Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Preparing for Ramadan. I think when people hear this phrase, preparing for Ramadan, we have very different ideas about what this means. For some, it may mean painting the house, getting rid of all the garbage in the yard, stocking the fridge with dates, perhaps some zamzam, getting the iftar treats ready and stocking the freezer with all sorts of delicacies. For others, it may mean a more spiritual insight of Ramadan, increasing in the recitation of Quran, making more salah, being in the masjid, fasting more so that we can get used to it. So these are all ideas of how to prepare for Ramadan, and I'd like to share my own. My understanding of preparing for Ramadan is to, number one, understand the objectives of Ramadan. What is Ramadan supposed to give us? What is Ramadan supposed to be about? Number two, finding out how does Allah Azza wa Jal bring about those objectives in our lives through Ramadan. In other words, what are the mechanisms that are utilized? And then thirdly, to expedite this process, to make sure that we make this happen as best as it possibly can and don't get in its way, don't get in the way of the process actually taking place. So let's look at it. The objectives of Ramadan are quite simple, very obvious. We've heard it so many times, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you may attain taqwa. What is taqwa? Taqwa is that quality, هِيَ مَلَكَةٌ تَحْمِلُ صَاحِبَهَا. It encourages and drives its owner, عَلَى امْتِثَالِ أَوَامِرِ اللَّهِ, to embody all of the commands of Allah, وَاجْتِنَابِ النَّوَاهِيهِ, and to refrain from all of His prohibitions. It's a conscience of God. It's a internal alarm that signals that evil is nearby, stay away from it, or that goodness is nearby, approach it. This is the internal quality known as taqwa. That's the objective of Ramadan, the ultimate objective of Ramadan. How does Allah bring this quality about in our lives? We see in the month of Ramadan that we are supposed to fast, and therefore fasting will bring us to taqwa. We see that we are supposed to spend our time with the Quran, because this was the habit of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He would read the Quran every night, study the Quran every night with Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, and finish the entire Quran or whatever was revealed of it during the month of Ramadan. And number three, we find certain acts of worship over and above fasting, like Salat al-Taraweeh and Tahajjud and Sadaqatul Fitr and other forms of charity during the month of Ramadan. And we find other things like staying away from sins and speaking badly about others and foul language, etc. So the objective is clear. We understand the mechanisms. How do the mechanisms bring us to those objectives? If we understand that Ramadan is supposed to bring about taqwa, and then we look at the mechanisms of fasting, we see that fasting deprives us of food, drink, and sexual intimacy from the time the sun comes up in the morning till the time the sun goes down. So essentially, we are depriving our animalistic instincts, our basic essentials of life, for a certain time period, to a certain degree, so that we can get this quality of taqwa. And just this mechanism alone can teach us something. That by depriving some of our normal activities, even our essential activities, we allow other elements within us to flourish and to grow, for tazkiyah to take place, for growth to take place. So imagine if we expedite this process. We don't only stay away from food, drink, and physical intimacy, but we also stay away from other things that we may not even assume to be bad for us, such as indulgences, entertainment, not watching movies and series in the month of Ramadan, not listening to music and radio programs in the month of Ramadan, limiting our social media interaction in the month of Ramadan. And through this, we actually expedite the process of this deprivation for growth to happen. Remember the basic verse in the Quran where Allah says that you will never attain, لَن تَنَالُ الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will never attain righteousness until you spend from that which you love. So the more you sacrifice and deprive yourself of during Ramadan, the more growth you'll experience. And that growth is taqwa. May Allah Ta'ala grant us taqwa and allow us to prepare ourselves for the month of Ramadan. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.